Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO, DBC Technology. And today we're going to review the Pro XG48 PoE, and we're going to compare it to the Enterprise Campus Switch 48 PoE. Unifi kindly sent out the Pro XG48 PoE to me, and I've had the ECS 48 PoE for some time. So I wanted to throw them side by side and compare them. Eventually, they're both going to go in the rack here at DBC Technology, and they will be part of our production system. So I wanted to take this opportunity while I was unboxing the Pro XG just to compare them both side by side. First of all, the Pro XG48 PoE is a very impressive unit. It comes with a very typical Unifi packaging. Everything's really well done. It also comes with a set of rack rails and all the hardware to mount ears on it or to put feet on it if you want to leave it on a countertop. Not sure that you would want to do that, but they're included if you did want to do that. Also comes with a power cord included, obviously. And speaking of power, that's going to be one of the major differences between the two units. On the front of the two units, they look similar, almost identical. On the back, you'll see this is where the major differences are. On the back of the ECS, you're going to have four hot swappable fans and two hot swappable power supplies, whereas on the back of the Pro XG48 PoE, you have five non-hot swappable fans and a single power input and the DC power input for an RPS unit. So obviously there's some differences there in the way they're delivering that power, the redundancy of that power, and the user serviceability of those fans and the power supplies. As far as the size goes, they are almost identical chassis, but the Enterprise Campus Switch has little tabs on the back of them for the hot swappable fans and power supplies. So it is a little deeper by a little bit over a half an inch. I also fired them both up individually and measured how loud they were at both startup and at idle. And so the ECS 48 PoE was 54.2 decibels at startup. And after about a 3 or 4 minute startup, it dropped down to 46.5 decibels. It also ran in the 50s under heavy load as well. The Pro XG48 PoE had very similar results. It was 56.5 at startup. And after the same 3 or 4 minute boot, it was running at about 45.5 decibels at idle. Both are what I would call quiet for enterprise level switch. Which is, I mean, obviously at this level, you're expecting there to be some noise, and typically 48 port PoE switches aren't the quietest, but I would classify these quiet. I will also say that the fan noise is not high pitched. It's a lower pitch fan noise. It's not that typical data center, server closet, you know, high pitched whine. It's more a low pitched moving air sound. And I don't think anybody in this market would be annoyed or upset with the amount of noise that it makes. But with that, let's jump into the software real quick. I wanna look at the Pro XG48 compared to the Enterprise Campus Switch and the stackable Enterprise Campus 48 PoE. And just see what the differences are and which one might be right for you if you're making that purchase decision. The easiest way to do this, I'm at store.ui.com and I'm just gonna click on switching. And I know these are down at the bottom. So I'm gonna scroll down and I'm gonna just hover over the Pro XG48 PoE and I'm gonna click the compare button. And it's gonna throw it down to the bottom here. And then I can go to Enterprise Campus and I can click compare on that. Now there are two versions of the Enterprise Campus 48 PoE. There is an upcoming version that is stackable. It is not in the comparison chart right now, but we'll go and take a look at it when we're done comparing the difference between these two units. So now that I've got those two selected, I'm gonna click on compare. And first and most obvious is the price difference here. The Pro XG48 PoE is $24.99, where the Enterprise Campus Switch is $34.99. So for $1,000 more, what are you getting? What sticks out the most to me is what is the same here. And the main thing is your ports and the port layout. First of all, they both have 16 2.5 gigabit PoE plus ports. And those are all backwards compatible all the way down to 10 meg. Same thing with both of them having 32 all PoE plus 10 gig ports. With those being backwards compatible, 10 gig, 5 gig, 2.5 gig, and all the way down to 10 meg. And they both have four 25 gig SFP 28 ports, and those are backward compatible to 10 and 1 gig. Same thing with all the ports being PoE plus. But there are some differences, and the easiest way to look at the differences is to just click the unique specs only here. And we're gonna go ahead and click on that. And it's gonna give me the things that are different between the units. So now you see all those ports are gone, and it's bringing me to the things that are different here. So the first and most obvious thing is the total PoE availability. So we're in the United States, so we're getting the 120 volts here. So we're getting 972 watts of power. Whereas with the two power supplies, we're getting 1700 available, or with one of them in 750 watts. So obviously there's a much higher power budget on the Enterprise Campus than there is on the Pro XG. That being said, a 1000 watt power budget is still pretty robust for the Pro XG 48. And as I mentioned before, we have DC power backup, that's with the RPS. And then we have two hot swappable PSUs on the Enterprise and four hot swappable fans on the enterprise campus, which is a nice feature to have. And if you need that level of redundancy and serviceability, you know, that $1,000 is quite a big jump, but those are pretty important things. Under form factor, the rack mount here, this one being full depth, meaning requiring a 4-post rack, I would say that's probably the true for both of them. These are big units, and just mounting them by a pair of rack ears is probably not going to be sufficient for the Pro XG either. So I would say that you plan on mounting these with rack rails for both of them. Forwarding rate, it looks like they're just more descriptive on that one. There is one layer 2 feature that the Pro XG 48 PoE has that the Enterprise Campus does not, and that's those Pro AV profiles. If you need those, you know who you are and you would be looking for those in particular. In this wattage per port difference, I'm gonna go back and compare all again here so you can see what is including and not including there. But they both have 90 watts on the PoE plus, and I assume that they probably stack down very similarly. That's probably just a documentation difference there than anything. I'm gonna go back into unique specs again. So max power consumption, we got 1172 here. Versus 2,400 or 2,500. So about half the power consumption. So under max power consumption, we're at 1,172 versus 2,400. Obviously they're both beasts, but 2,400 is quite a bit there for the enterprise campus. Under power method, we've obviously got the two plugs on the back of the redundant power supplies on the ECS. And we've got the single power input plus the USB RPS DC input on the back of the Pro XG. Power supply, we've got the one 1350 watt internal versus the two 1200 watt power supplies in the ECS. Heat dissipation, I just think that's not listed there for the Pro XG. And weight, obviously they weigh a little bit different. They're similar, but the ECS is a little bit heavier. And the mount material, and so that's pretty much it for the differences. If you go back to the specs and you undo the unique specs only, you can see these are really impressive layer 3 switches. They've got all the goodies, and you can go up on store.ui and do your comparison yourself. One more thing that I did want to talk about on the Enterprise Campus 48 PoE is that there is a stacking version. And what that stacking version does, if you can see on the back of the regular ECS 48 PoE, you have those four fans and the two hot swappable power supplies. If you go to stacking, on the back of it, you're adding these two 100 gigabit USFP 28 ports, and those are for stacking one to another, and you have these management and console ports, which are different than they are on the standard. And so that goes from $349.99 to $399.99. So it's $500 to have those 100 gig stacking ports on it. So if you've gotten to this point and you're buying $4,000, which is, you know whether that is the right option for you or not. And that brings me back to the Pro XG 48 PoE. First of all, I've had the Enterprise Campus switch for a couple of months now, and I really enjoy it a lot. It's cool to have the 10 gig. It's cool to have the PoE plus on everything and not really have to worry about what port you're plugging in things. And it's much easier to manage it as far as just everything gets all the goodies. But the coolest thing for me at DPC Technology, and I've bought several of them actually, I just bought another one, is the Switch Flex 2.58 PoE, which is that little 8-port PoE switch that can be powered by the PoE++. It will deliver PoE++. So what that allows me to do is I've got all these test rigs around the office. We have a bench, I have a test rig for indoor cameras, I have a test rig for outdoor cameras, and then I have another rig on the other side of the building where I was testing the LPR cameras. So I have four of these things running, and it lets me deliver PoE++ to 8 ports without having any power to it. The cool thing about the Pro XG is now we're gonna be able to bring that same experience down to $1,000 less price point, which I think is gonna be very appealing to some people. For the mission critical stuff, if you need that redundancy of the multiple power supplies, or if you are going to be running a ton of PoE++ devices off this and you need the power budget, well, that $1,000 to go up to the enterprise campus may make sense for you. And even beyond that, if you are gonna stack several of these things together and power a bunch of devices, the S version of the Enterprise Campus 48 PoE may make sense for you to be able to stack those together with that 100 gig connectivity in between everything. So in addition to the Pro XG 48 PoE, they are also dropping the 24 PoE, the 10 PoE, and an 8 PoE. Those are gonna be priced at $17.99 for the 24, $699 for the 10, and $499 for the 8 PoE. There is also gonna be an XG aggregation. There's one other item being released today, which is the USW-WAN, which will be $399. I will be doing an upcoming review of that when I pair that with our Enterprise Gateway switches and the Pro XG and the Enterprise Campus switch when we get our rack all together here. That should be coming out soon when we do our full reveal of our 2025 Unifi rack setup. If you have any questions about the Pro XG 48 PoE or any of these other new switches, please put them in the comments down below, and we'll see you guys in the next video.